Hello student, in last two video we study about the sexual reproduction in flowering plant. In last video we observe the structure of the microsporangium. In microsporangium, outermost structure is known epidermis, endothecium, middle layer, tapetum. All these things we study in last video. Now we study all these things one by one briefly. So let we start structure of anther. In the transverse section of anther, it is seen almost tetragonal, and microsporangium appears near circular in outline. You observe in the diagram also the four microsporangium are present in a anther. Okay, in dithecous anther, the following structures are present in the anther. First, outermost layer is known as epidermis. It is outermost layer of anther. It is single celled thick layer, but not archisporeal in origin. It forms the outermost protective layer. It means epidermis is a protective layer which protect the microsporangium and pollen sac. Okay, protective layer. And next layer is known as endothecium. Present below the epidermis, it is single cell thick layer. During the maturation of anther, various changes take place in different walls of cell of endothecium. One more thing, endothecium is absorbing moisture from outside also. The outermost wall of these cells remain thin, but inner walls and radial walls become thick due to thickening of alpha cellulose fibers. Callose band are also present along the radial wall. At some places, callose bands and fibrous thickening are absent. These places are called stromium. Through stromium, the microsporangium is dehiscent and pollen grain are come out from the pollen sac. The dehiscence of anther take place only from these places. Endothecium become hygroscopic in nature due to presence of fibrous thickening. Hygroscopic means they absorb moisture from the environment. And third layer is middle layer. Middle layer consists of parenchyma cells. This layer is one of three celled thick structure. Food is stored by parenchymatous cell. It is parenchymatous. Parenchymatous means they store food material, okay, for the development of the pollen grain. Middle layer is ephemeral, short lived in nature and absent in mature anther. Okay, in mature anther, middle layer is degenerative because the nutrition which is stored in middle layer is consumed by tapetum. So that's why the middle layer is not present in the mature anther. Next layer is tapetum. Tapetum is also known as nutritive layer. It is innermost layer which acts as nutritive layer. This is single celled layer thick. The cell of tapetum are initially diploid, but they become polyploids and multinucleated due to the endomitosis and free nuclear division respectively. Okay, so tapetum is a nutritive layer. When pollen grains are developing in pollen sac, first of all pollen mother cells are developed, then pollen mother cell is converted into pollen tetrad, then pollen tetrad is converted into pollen grain. So during this development, some nutrition is required, and this these nutritions are provided by tapetum to the developing microspore or pollen grain. Tapetum absorb food from the middle layer and provide nutrition to the microspore mother cell or developing microspore. The tapetum disappear in the mature anther because this tapetum is consumed by the developing pollen grain. So the tapetum it disappear in the mature anther. Now we discuss about type of tapetum. First type of tapetum is amoeboid tapetum. It is also known as invasive tapetum, or it is also called periplasmodial tapetum. It is found in primitive angiosperm. Okay, primitive means old angiosperm. Such type of tapetum absorb all food from middle layer. This type of tapetum provide nutrition to developing microspore after degeneration. First of all, this tapetum is degenerated, then this tapetum provide nutrition to the developing microspore. For example, typha. Typha is a hydrophyte. Okay, alisma, tradescantia. These are the example of amoeboid tapetum. In many time NEET examination, this question occur Which one is having amoeboid epitome? The four plants name are given: Typha, Alyssemia, Tradescantia. If one plant is given from these plant, so the right answer is Typha or Alyssema or Tradescantia. Second type of tapetum is glandular or secretory tapetum. This is advanced type of tapetum. It does not degenerate quickly. Okay, as comparison to amoeboid tapetum, the glandular tapetum is not degenerated quickly. It absorbs nutrient from the middle layer and secrete into the cavity of the microsporangia. The cavity of microsporangia is known as pollen sac. Usually it is found in most of the flowering plant. So one important point is here, before degeneration of cell of tapetum, they form special granules called proubious bodies in cytoplasm. Here they are surrounded by sporopollenin. Sporopollenin. Now they are called ubiquitous body or ubicules. At last, tapetum degenerates and ubiquitous body are released into pollen sac. The sporopollenin is an organic compound. The hardest organic compound in entire world is known as sporopollenin. And sporopollenin originate the outermost layer of the pollen grain. It is known as exine. So the exine of the pollen grain is made up by sporopollenin. Now we discuss about function of tapetum. Tapetum provide nutrition to the microspore mother cell, MMC, microspore mother cell, or PMC, primordial mother cell. PMC means primordial mother cell or primary mother cell, or developing pollens. Secretion of sporopollenin and pollen kit material, secretion of enzyme and hormone, formation of ubiquitous body. Now we discuss about development of anther and microsporogenesis. How the anther is developed, okay, how the microsporogenesis occur. Microsporogenesis means development of microsporangia in the pollen sac is known as microsporogenesis. The development of anther is eusporangiate type. There are two kind of development, eusporangiate and heterosporangiate. In eusporangiate type, it is developed from more than one archisporial cell. More than one, not only one, more than one. The anther appear as outgrowth like structure in the initial stage, which show spherical or oval shaped structure. At this stage, it is a mass of meristematic cell. Mass of meristematic cell means dividing cells, because in meristematic cell they are always dividing form, which is surrounded by a single celled thick layer. This layer is known as epidermis. First of all vascular tissues are formed in middle region. Simultaneously, group of cells which are located just below the epidermis in vertical rows of hypodermal region at the four corners become large. These cells are called archisporial cell. We discuss this theory in diagram also. In diagrammatic representation, you easily describe the structure of the development of anther or microsporogenesis. Archisporial cell divide periclinally. Archisporial cell divide periclinally to form primary parietal cell and primary sporogenous cell. Two cells are formed by archisporial cell after periclinal division. First cell is known as parietal cell and second cell is known as primary sporogenous cell. Primary parietal cell undergo further periclinal and anticlinal division to form a series of 3 to 5 layer, making the wall of anther. Making the wall of anther. Wall of anther means the epidermis, the middle layer, the tapetum. All these layers are formed by which cell? Parietal cell. The primary sporogenous cell divide by mitotic division. Important point, which division is occur in pollen sac? Mitotic division in sporogenous cell. To form sporogenous cells or sporogenous tissues and later sporogenous cells. Differentiate into microspore mother cell during the formation of wall of pollen sac. Each microspore mother cell or cells of sporogenous tissues divides to form four haploid microspore or pollen grain by mitotic division or reduction division, by meiosis division or reduction division, because meiosis division is known as reductional division. All the initial stages, all four microspores are attached together with the help of callosity layer. This group of microspores is called tetrad. After some time, this callosity layer is dissolved by callase enzyme, which is secreted by tapetum. After the formation of Ubich body, the tapetum layer degenerate. Ubich body participate in the formation of exine of the microspore inside the pollen cell. When pollen grain is developed, the structure of the pollen grain we discuss now. In pollen grain, one, intine is present. On the intine, exine is present, and one germ pore is present. One nucleus is present, cytoplasm is present. And this exine is made up by sporopollenin. Sporopollenin is originated by which layer? Tapetum. The inner layer is known as intine. Nucleus is present. When these pollen grains are pollinated and they are introduced on the stigma of the carpel, okay, if the species is same, because pollen grain germinate when species is same, because fertilization is always species specific. When these pollen grains are introduced on the stigma, they get moisture from the stigma and germinate. A pollen tube is come out from the germ pore. A pollen tube is arises. In this pollen tube, on the tip of the pollen tube, one tube nucleus is present and two male gametes are present. Through the style, these pollen grain migrate into the ovule, and in ovule fertilization occur. Later on we study about what is fertilization. So friend, in next video we discuss about megasporogenesis, and first of all we study about microsporogenesis and diagrammatic representation of the tetrad. Various type of tetrads are present in the angiosperm. So thank you for watching my video.